A man was stabbed to death after a man posing as a census worker invaded his home. Hey guys, it's May 12th, 2010. My name is Reginald. I'm also known as Dumbcat. In Houston, a man posed as a census worker and he was able to get inside a house. And he attacked the people who lived there. And when the victim, when the man who was killed walked into the house, he was ambushed by three guys. They tied him up and they stabbed him to death. Okay, they did that and then they submerged him underwater. This was in front of, I believe his wife, and it's horrible. So guys, be careful. Okay, gold hits a 5-month high on Eurozone debt concerns. Basically, that $1 trillion in bailout package over there in Europe has made some people kind of nervous about all these fiat currencies. Gee, I wonder why. Gold has made some pretty big jumps lately, so it looks like some people's predictions are coming true, and we'll see if my silver and gold prediction comes true for this year. you know how I feel about predictions. Okay, mortgages. Strategic defaults are on the rise. I've been telling you guys this for several months. In the first wave of this mortgage default crisis, it was basically people who had some really bad loans and they really couldn't afford it. Basically, they bought houses that they couldn't afford. But now we're starting to see a lot more people who can afford a home walk away. And what's happening is that a lot of people are underwater. They have a mortgage that's, what, $300,000, but then the house is only worth $225,000. A lot of people are saying, you know what, I'm not going to pay for something that's not even worth the mortgage. And they're walking away. And strategic defaults accounted for at least 12% of all defaults in February, up from about 4% in mid-2007. This is according to a recent report by Morgan Stanley. What we're seeing is that consumer spending has increased 3.6% in the last quarter, and we're seeing unemployment go up. So I think what you're having is people stop paying their mortgages, and they're basically spending money on something else. And maybe this is contributing to the increase, consumer spending increasing. Okay, SEC has said that there's not likely that one event caused the market plunge. Basically, Mary Shapiro of the Securities and Exchange Commission, she's a chairwoman, and Gary Gensler, the Commodities Future Trading Commissioner chairman, both refuted speculations that a trader might have made a so-called fat finger error that contributed to the stock market plunge. Very interesting. I still can't believe they use that ridiculous excuse. I mean, what an idiotic excuse. They must really think we're dumb. The mainstream media must really think we're stupid. I'm glad that somebody's willing to come out and point out the obvious. And no, that wasn't a joke. Okay, U.S. exposure to European Union bailout is big, but risk is limited. Really. Yeah, okay. The U.S. exposure to the European debt bailout could be at least $50 billion, but the chance of taxpayers actually being on the hook for that appears remote. It appears remote. It appears remote. In other words, you're not quite sure. The U.S. will be responsible for 17.0% or $54 billion of the cost of a quota contribution system that the IMF uses in such instances. The U.S. is a leading contributor under this quota system. It looks like the IMF is going to end up paying about $250 billion. We'll see how much this really costs us, okay? Okay, project to demolish 450 houses starts in Detroit. Basically, they're going to get rid of a lot of these raggedy houses, all these abandoned houses. These are dubbed the 450 most dangerous structures within the city. And this is part of Wayne County's project. Wayne County is teaming up with some religious groups, and it's a $4.5 million project. And it's being backed by Wayne County, but Wayne County received their money from the stimulus package. Well, you guys know how I feel about the stimulus package, but at least they're tearing down these houses. And I was wondering how they were going to be able to really pay for all this. But federal tax dollars is going towards tearing this down. So how do you guys feel about that? I'm just glad it's being torn down, but at the same time, why call it a stimulus package if it's not really stimulating much of anything? But I guess you can argue differently. All right, four big banks score perfect 61-day run. Yes! despite the running unease in the world markets, four giant American finance managed to make money from trading every single day during the first 3 months of the year. Their remarkable 61-day streak is one for the record books. Perfect trading. Perfect trading quarters on Wall Street are as rare as a no-hitter in baseball. And, well, it's actually a recent no-hitter. but anyway, Bank of America, Citigroup, Goldman Sachs, JP Morgan Chase managed to essentially have perfect games in trading, essentially. They didn't lose money in one day. Not one day in the last quarter. Okay. I guess they just run really, really, really well. You know, so well that they needed bailouts like a couple years ago. Oh, it's all going to come crashing down. Okay, manufacturing sector accounts for 24% of mass April layoffs. Now, the mass April layoffs weren't as intense as they were a year earlier, but employers initiated 1,564 mass layoff events in the first quarter of 2010. About 24% of them were in the manufacturing sector. So things aren't as bad. Well, things are deteriorating at the same rate as they were last year, but they're still deteriorating. Okay. I hope you got that. All right, guys. Thank you guys for watching this video. Feel free to listen to the radio show. Is that Sunday radio show I did with Barnwall? That was really, really good. She knew a lot. I learned a lot, so I'll put a link in my description box if you guys want to check that out. She knew a lot about finance and banking, and I learned a lot about the Federal Reserve, and check it out. All right, guys. Thank you for watching this video. Take care. Have a good day. All right, and remember, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.